Welcome, I'm Colleen. We're gonna be doing a combo class today, spin into focus core work. You're gonna want your mat, spin bike, towel, water. Join me when you're ready. Let's get clipped in and begin our ride together. As you can tell, no fancy bike here, no computer monitoring. I'm gonna be using rate of perceived exertion and do some cadence checks along the way. Encourage you to do the same with me, or if you do have computer monitoring, you'll utilize those devices for your output and cadence checks. So go ahead and let yourself fully arrive in your space on your bike at the beginning of an awesome workout. Like I said, we'll be doing the cycling, get our cardio and strength, your hips down, and then take it to the mat. We'll focus on side body, front of the body, and back body for core focus. So you want to have resistance under you that you can feel, flat road, beginning of the warm-up. Press back away from those handlebars, take a deep inhale, exhale, let it go, inhale, exhale, one more, deep inhale in, full exhale out. And then settle yourself. You want the glutes near the widest part of the saddle. The feet are flat as you come over the top of that stroke. Knees tracking over toes. Hands are at first or second position on the handlebars. Shoulders are dropped down and away from the ears. Elbows are soft. Knees are floating up. Equal energy and rhythm into the right and left leg. As we work through the warm-up cadence right now, continue to move those legs anywhere 80 to 100. If you're not sure, for 15 seconds, we'll count it out. So go ahead and count how many times that right leg comes up towards that right elbow. End that count, multiply by four. There is your cadence. Again, 80 to 100 right now. Begin to connect with breath, deep belly breath. Using the full capacity of the diaphragm, inhaling to fill up, exhaling to release the breath completely. Feeling good, let's reach down, let's make a little gain. Try not to have it affect our cadence. We've got breaking down the stroke. It's a push from 12 to 6, a pull from 6 to 12. Targeting quads as you press down, hamstrings, glutes as you pull up. Minute 30 right now, left of the warm up. And we'll take it out of the saddle, begin to explore second and third position. Going at any point during the workout, you need to take it back to the saddle, take water as you need. Rate of perceived exertion on a scale from 1 to 10, 1 being no effort, 10 being all out effort. I want you working at a challenge point for you. Maybe that's 7, 8, 9, you would get going, maybe 10. You want to be able to recover that breath soon through the workout. The saddle is always there for you at any point. 50 seconds. Reach down, make a gain. Knees float up, but it's flat from the top of that stroke. Shoulders naturally want to creep up, so recheck and let them lower down. Spine is long, light touch in those hands, not bearing down. Final 25, and then we're transitioning out of the saddle. Moving past our warm-up. Before we take it into uphill climb third, take some more tension underneath you. A couple turns. Gain a couple numbers. Cadence range now moves from 60 to 80. That's your window. Right now, let's keep it in the high 70s. Hands are at the end.
end of the handlebars. Glutes have shifted back. Hips sitting over pedals. Glutes getting tapped by the back edge of that saddle. Even push to pull. Energy moves right, left, back again. Bird's going to transition to standing, running second around the corner. Get ready for it. Keep the cadence. Rise up, stand up. Straight pedal stroke down through those heels. Feel that rhythm. Let that beat carry you. Perfect position for deep belly breath here. Find yours. Power push, power pull. And back out to third in 5, 4, 3, 2, hands to five, glute shift back out. Work those numbers in the low 70s, adding more tension. Maintain effort. Light touching hands. Shoulders soft. Chest open. Push, pull. Final 30 right here. 20. Saddle. Hydrate. Lat road. Sprint. 110 is the highest number we see in a sprint. No gains. Fast there. The first one begins now. Let's hit 105. Start. 105. Feeling that wheel, but able to push through it. Maintain effort, looks good. Back it off. Add a gain. That felt good. Next time we hit 110, no higher. You're over 110, you're stronger than you think. Time to add more tension to the equation. Go. Maintain that pace. Like you're going as quick as they can against the tension you feel. Protect those joints. Knees tracking over toes. Back it off. Check in. Time to hydrate if you need. Towel. And then make a gain. Do a quarter turn, gain a number. Go. Each sprint progressively getting harder. Make it so. Continue to raise the bar, and then we rise to the bar we've set for ourselves. Accomplishing goals. Evoking change. We got this. In. You want to get stronger? I do. I'm going to add a little more. Then I'm going to try to still hit that 110 and maintain that effort. Go. Keep it up. Keep it up. Towel. Make a little increase in tension. Get ready to go out of the gate. We begin. Soft shoulders and elbows. Length of the spine. Try not to compress. Stay lifted and lengthened. You. Yes, back it off. Feeling good. Little gain. Quarter turns add up. Those numbers add up. Let's go. In, make a gain, we're closing in on it. Almost a minute to the finish line. We go again. Full effort in, scale from 1 to 10, 8, 9, maybe 10. Maintaining deep belly breath, listen to your body. We go. Full out effort. In 110, holding 110. Final 5, 4, 3, 2.
Awesome work.
Begin to move towards a climb mentality. We're gonna start seated. Tension comes up, hands range back to 60 to 80. But I want you in the 60s, working for those numbers. Tension is up. Cadence has slowed down for putting more power behind those strokes. If you're not sure where you are on that cadence scale, we'll do that 15 second check beginning in 3, 2, 1. Count how many times that right leg floats up. And the cadence check, multiply by 4, there's your output. Yes. Feeling each and every stroke, the power in the legs as you move through that stroke. Push, 12-6, pull, 6-12. Quads, hamstrings, glutes and calves, recruit them. Feel power. Same breath. We'll make our move to uphill climb third, around the corner. Coming out in 25. As we transition out, we take more tension underneath us. Increase the vertical in 10. 5. Gain tension. Come on out. And step out, glute shift back. That energy right, left, and back again. Keep your focus. Remember why you're here. Goals, the ambitions, just being able to move, relish that, have gratitude for that. Keep it. We work through it in 4, three, two, saddle back. Hardest round seated yet. Recovery, 20 seconds, 30 on, 20 off. Now recovery, time to grab water. Set to maybe gain a little bit more tension. Sprint progressively more challenging. Go in three, two, full sprint speed. Touching breathlessness. Great perceived exertion, 9-10. More seconds. Three, two, take that recovery. 20 seconds. Take out the tension. Reset focus, resistance. Three, two, one, we begin again, 30 on. Enjoy the work, enjoy the process. Ten more seconds, and then we recover. Push on. Five, three, two, one, back off the push. 20 seconds, your time. Ten seconds more, and then it's go time. 30 seconds of sprint work. Tension gain. Three, two, one, go. Maintains. Another 10, and then we get that recovery. Push it. Four, three, two, back up. Reach down, make a little gain. seconds, we go live. Closing in on our time on the bike. Make the most of it. 3, 2, 30 seconds, go. Second to last sprint, you got this. Sprint to the finish line. Get through this cycling work. We'll be on the mat in no time. Focus on core. 3, 2, final push. 40 seconds, gaining an extra 10 seconds of challenge. 110, you hit it, you hold it. Slow down that leg speed, taking off a little bit of tension, moving into that cool down mentality.
Yeah.
Stop right before left foot back, feet level and flat. Rise up out of the saddle, hands, the end of the hip bars, glute shift back. Left foot forward, right foot back, shift hips, feel length and hamstrings and calves. Great work with the cycling. Heart rate should be back down. Take it to the mat, so slowly dismount, moving into socks or barefoot, your choice. Sip of water. Letting yourself mentally transition from that cycling movement to focus core now. So let's take a deep inhale to reach, lengthen, exhale, let it go. One more inhale. Exhale, last one, inhale, reach, lengthen. And you are invited cordially to our plank party. Join me when you're ready. Coming all the way down. When we hit that plank, let's take two cat-cows. Belly fall, shoulders draw back, eyes up. Exhale, round through the spine. Eyes to navel, one more. Forearm plank work begins. Elbow, shoulder alignment, feet step back. Shoulder hips through activated heels pressing back. Too much tension? Drop those knees. Always a modification. Take them if you need them. Shoulders down to hips, down to kneecap, straight line, or shoulders, hips to heels. Want more tension? Soft forward and back. Four, three, two, left elbow down. For ultimate challenge, feet are stacked. Less challenge, staggered, modified. Bottom leg long, top leg bent behind. Just choose where you want to spend the time. Try to focus that bottom hip and lift it up. Draw the belly button in towards the spine. 10. 5. Smooth transition. Stack the joints. Arrive. Same leg position. Lift the bottom hip. Out the breath, draw the belly in. Ten. Five. Center. Drop the knee. Move to child. From child, rise to table. Hands under shoulders. Curl up the toes underneath and hover those kneecaps. Inch, inch and a half off the mat. Elbows soft, not locked out. Stay with it. 5, 4, 3, 2, child. Let the child be your reset. We're moving into our second plank party. Full plank, hands under shoulders, unless it's too much for the joints, and then please come back to forearms. All the way up or knees down. Nothing fancy, just really owning this full plank. Fingers spread wide, elbows soft, shoulders over wrists, shoulders, hips to knees, shoulders, hips to heels. Fire the quads, 10. 5. Side plank. Again, too much pressure on the wrists. Come onto that forearm. If not, full plank. Arm under shoulder.
Enjoy the challenge, embrace the challenge. 10. 5. Move to the opposite side. 5, 4, 3, 2, slide hands on back to child, let that be your reset. Child to table, curl toes, hover knees, hold. Down dog. Inhale, rise the breath forward. Exhale, lead with the hips. Back. Arrive, plank hold. As slowly as possible, take your time. All find your way onto the earth. Arms long, legs long. Rise up. Hover position. Draw goddess arms, butter kick legs. Ten. Five. Stack the hands, bend the knees, windshield wiper those legs. Go ahead and roll onto your back. Lengthen arms, lengthen legs. Inhale, arms to ears, exhale, rise up. Tap toes, restack straight spine. Slow articulation back down. This time, right arm towards outside of left foot. Reset, hollow out through the core and lower. Rise up, left arm to outside of right foot. Lower. Center, rise up. Tap. Lower. Hollow out through the core. Right hand to left foot at the top. Left hand to right foot. Up and down and through till the world blows up. Hands beneath the head. Point the toes, ground the legs, crunch. As you rise, weight of the head in the hands. Slight nod of chin to chest. Gaze at those toe tips at the top. 10. Inches. Do not need to connect. Repeater, right elbow, left leg, 10. Left elbow, right knee, 10. Six.
3. 2.
Head down, knees in. Lengthen legs, point toes, wave the head in the hands. Crunch second round. Starting to feel the accumulation of the repetitions, the warmth in the core. Three, two, head down, bend those legs. Repeat our right elbow, left knee, 10. Five. Left elbow, right knee, go. Five. Knees in, release tension in that low back, and then place the feet, clamp the palms down, and then lift the hips to the sky, bridge pose. Shoulders to kneecaps. Stay here, lengthen the right leg to full extension, hold. Pull the weight into the right once it arrives. Lengthen the left, hold. Left leg down. Stay here, add in a little pulse. Hips drop halfway down and then rise. Squeeze the glutes back up. Six. Five. Four. Three, two, hold at the top, stay here, hover those heels. Stay here, catch the feet, tap the heels. Five, three, two, heels down, slow articulation down, close the knees in. Right knee in, left leg long, draw up and gaze over right shoulder. Bicycle, left knee in, look left, right. Five, four, three, two, head heavy, knees in. Lengthen legs, point toes. One more round of work here. Crunch. Wave the head in the hand. We're holding a tennis ball between chin and chest. Five. Three. Two. Head heavy, knees in. Heels down, toes up. Alternate to finish the crunch. Onto your left side. Legs and table, bottom arm down. You can draw elbow towards top hip if you want more intensity. You draw the legs in as the elbow rises up. Fancy little spin to find your way onto the opposite side. Same game. Elbow towards hip. You added the legs on the other side, use them on this side. Side body awareness.
10. Five. Final one. Roll onto that belly. Lengthen arms, lengthen legs, rise up, hold. Layer in, swimming, alternating arms and legs. Ten. Five. Stack the hands, bend the knees, windshield wiper those legs. One more for back body strength, and then we stretch the body. Arms long, legs long, toes and heels together, rise up, hold up, focus. Neck is long, gaze just ahead of the mat. 10. 5. Slide the hands under the shoulders, press back, child. Breathe into that back body. Find your way to down dog. Lift and lower those heels, pedal it out. So keep one heel high, one heel low. Getting into some of those cycling muscles, hamstrings, glutes, calves. Walk the feet towards the hands. Take an inhale to create length. Exhale, fold and hold. Shake your head yes and no. Take the right foot over the left. Keep that left leg long. Bend that right knee. You should be feeling the stretch in the back of that left leg. I don't understand blame by the same hand. How do you find rise up and switch. To the right, left knee's now bent, right leg is long, head heavy. Cross those legs, rise up slowly. Come back towards your bike to use that as support as we stretch the quads. Right hand on the bike, left heel draws towards the glutes, knees draw together, hip point presses forward. Great work today. Solid effort on the bike. Finishing that solid effort by targeting the core. Release the left. Pull in on that right. Hold hands on the bike. Take that right foot. Flex foot above the left knee and then sink those hips for reverse pigeon. On an inhale, rise. Right foot ground, left leg draws high onto that right quad above the knee and then we sink. Rise up. Reach those fingertips away from the hips then move to the right. Rise center. Move left. One more. Rise. Move right. Rise. Move left. Lengthening the core. Circling the arms back, opening that chest. Exhale. Press the palms away, chin to chest. Gaze down. Get any tension in those wrists. Take a couple standing torso twists. Getting rid of any tension in the upper mid, low back. Two more grounding breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. Great work today. Look forward to working with you again. Be well. Thanks for joining me. I'm Colleen. We're going to be doing a group training class today, which means cardio, strength, body weight, and weighted work. You're going to want your mat, water, towel, sneakers, two sets of free weights, something on the higher, more challenging end. I'm going to be using 15s, something a little bit lighter. 10s is my choice, but you do you. And then when you're ready, settle yourself into your space. Let's take a couple deep belly breaths just to ground ourselves down. Inhale to reach the arms. Exhale, release any tension, holding, stress you came into the space with. Inhale, reach. Exhale, release. Inhale, reach, extend. Exhale, release, and let go. A couple standing spinal twists. We're going to be working with greater perceived exertion today on a scale from 1 to 10, 1 being nothing, 10 being all-out effort. I want you working in a safe zone for you. Maybe pushing 8, 9, maybe breathless 10 if that's appropriate. Taking breaks, taking in water whenever you need to. Let's go ahead and take some jumping jacks. If it's too quick for the jack, step right, step left. Four, three, two. Let's go ahead and warm up those shoulders. Alternating windmill forward. Windmill back. Standing cat-cow, feet are hip-width apart. Hands to the thighs, take an inhale, draw the belly in and chin to chest. Exhale, release the belly down, drop the shoulders back, eyes look up. Exhale, round, curl, tuck. Exhale, release, gaze up, two more. Spinal twist, open your stance, drop the shoulder and twist, looking over your opposite shoulder. On an exhale, release to the other side, drop the shoulder and twist. One more to the right. One more to the left. Back center, heel toe the feet in, jumping jack. Chest, let yourself bend the knees and have the hands meet the mat. Once they have, walk the hands out, hold high plank, and then set the right foot in. Let the left hand arrive inside of the right foot and twist. Right arm high, left arm low. Press through that left heel. One more inhale here, exhale, right hand down. Step the right foot back, left foot forward, right hand moves to the inside of left foot, then left arm goes high. Left hand down, left foot back, walk the hands back to the feet. Knee soft, head heavy, rise up. One more, chin chest, roll on down. Walk out, high plank. Hold. Step right foot in, left hand plants, right arm rotates high. Right hand down, right foot back, left foot forward, right hand inside, left foot left, arm high. Left hand down, left foot back, hands back to feet, knees soft, head heavy. Back to the jumping jacks. Infuse cardio along with the strength to get the gains. Crisscross. Involve a little work with some punching today, a few kicks. Let's just begin to practice or boxer shuffle. Finding yourself in space, moving energy right to left, drawing the hands up on guard. So we'll be doing
left foot forward, right foot back, striking the left and right arm. Boxer shuffle center. We want to bring balance. Be as strong on the right as we're on the left, so we will be practicing right foot forward, left foot back, striking the right and left. Back center. Go ahead and just break down the basic function of our punches. So find that stance. And as we strike, we're gonna punch out, coming over the top of the arm, striking with the front two knuckles. Thumb is wrapped, but would be pointing down. Draw back. Recoil. 90% of full extension of the punch, so there's a soft elbow, so you're not hyperextending. So this is our jab, front jab. And we're gonna come from a cross jab with a back arm. Notice the pivot. We pivot, cross jab, recoil. Pivot, recoil. 90% of full extension. Good. Boxer shuffle. Protect that face. Switch up that lead leg. Find stillness. Punch. Punch. Four, three, two. Cross, add that pivot, recoil. Starting slow, we'll begin to build the speed. Just want to review the basics. Four, three, two, one, shuffle. Jumping jack. Heel taps. Grab your imaginary jump rope and begin hopping. Be a bunny hop. Lateral movement side to side, forward and back. Four, three, two. Side shuffle. We're working front to back and side to side today. We always want to be able to move with power in all directions, so we'll train for that. To the right, one more to the left. Tap down with a bunny hop. So right hand taps down. One, two, hop, left. Two more. Big deep inhale. Exhale, grab a little sip of water. Here's the game. It's gonna be fun. We're gonna do jab, cross, jab, cross, burpee. Options, hands down, step the feet back or hop the feet back, step the feet in or hop the feet in, stand up or jump up. So again, you're in charge of the intensity. Two jab crosses, two burpees, right side, rise up, same game. Left side. See how this goes. You ready? Jab, cross, jab, cross, burpee. Switch the stance. Make sure you get that pivot in. Repeat. We got this. One more on each side. Jab, cross. Jab, cross. Burpee. Jab, cross. Jab, cross. Burpee. Awesome. Easy peasy. Squats. Feet. Hip width apart.
I said we'll be involving some kicks. Warming up the legs, basic squat. 4, 3, 2. Snap kick, left foot forward, hands up. You're gonna chamber the kick, toe down, strike for the laces, re-chamber, step back. Good, chamber, strike, chamber, return. 4, 3, 2. Shuffle it out. Take one nice and slow, left foot back. Chamber, strike, chamber, return to stance. Find balance. If you lose it, find your way back to it. 5, 4, 3, 2. Lateral lunge. Come to one side of your space, move into that right leg. Right knee is bent, knees striking over toes, left leg long. Tap. Think inner and outer thigh. Mentally connect with the muscles as we're working them to target them more. 4, 3, 2. Side shuffle to the right, step to the left. Four, three, two. Reverse lunge, right foot steps back. Step in, keep the right foot flowing. Stepping directly behind you, back heel stays lifted. 4, 3, 2. Left foot. 5, 4, 3, 2. Curtsy, stationary. So we're in an open plié position. So both hips are open. Back foot steps directly behind front foot. Back heel is lifted. We come down, knees track over those toes, rise up. Find yourself, if you need a wall or something for stability, please find it. Create a diamond on the way down, zip it up on the way up. Super effective exercise to target the outer thighs. Take your time, we're not gonna rush through these. We're gonna move with intention and purpose. 4, 3, 2. Beautiful. Right foot steps out, open hip, left foot steps back, left heel lifted. Both toes turned out. Create the diamond, rise up. Again, not rushing it, high quality movements. 5, 4, 3. 2. Great work. Grab some water. Grab your larger set of weights, please. Bicep curls. We're going to start with the arms working together. So it's going to be a hammer curl. We're going to draw up. Palms face the shoulders at the top. Extend. Palms face the sides of the bodies at the bottom. Getting a little tricep on the kickback. Slow controlled movements. Again, not rushing the work. 5, 4, 3,
two. Beautiful. Arnold press. We're going to start with those weights at the shoulders, palms facing the shoulders. You're going to press up, palms turn away as the knuckles press to the top. Use the exhale as you press, the inhale as you lower. Feet are hip width apart, knees soft, core strong. Four. Three. Two. Upright row. Palms face the thighs now. Draw up, elbows lead. Weight stops at chest. Feel the work on the way up, the work on the way down. We're working a two count. One, two up, one, two down. Four. Three. Two. Bent over back row. Feet, hip width, knees soft. Hinge at the hips, creating that flat back. And then row. Again, arms work together. Elbows lead. Five. Four. Three. Two. Bigger weights go down. Smaller weights come up. Reverse fly. Staggered stamps. Soft elbows. Rise up. Return down. Resist resistance. Slow, controlled. One, two. One, two. Two more. Out to a T. Shoulder height. Good. Four. Three. Two. Weights down. Shake it out. Jumping jack. Back to the jab, cross, burpee, right. Jab, cross, burpee, left. Set yourself up for success. Remember to get that pivot as you throw that cross jab. Jab, cross, jab, cross, burpee. Jab, cross, burpee. One more on each side. Jump rope. Heel taps. Three, two, squat. Four, three, two. Heel strike now with that kick. So we'll chamber, flex the foot, strike with the bottom heel of the foot. So get that stance, chamber. Strike, chamber, reset. Five, four, three, two. Shake it out. Reset. Strike. Foot flexed. 5, 4, 3, 2, lateral work, lunge, instep tap. Five, four, three, two, quick shuffle to the right, step left. Five, four, three, two. Work on a little balance. Warrior three. So pour the weight into the left. Draw that right knee high. And then draw that right leg behind you. It could be a high warrior or more traditional. Soft bend in that knee. Trust that standing leg. 10, 5, rise up, high knee, replace the knee, long leg, pour weight through right, lift the left, set yourself up, and begin the movement forward. 5, left foot is flexed, right knee is soft, 10, 5, rise up, take that knee up, return the leg down, pick up your weights, grab a sip of water first. The first round of work, arms worked together. We're now gonna alternate. So that hammer curl, but right arm moves first, left arm follows. Weights pass at the halfway point. This one's already moving up because the other one's coming down. Four, three, two. Nice. Arnold press, same game, alternating. Right moves, right draws down as the left arm's headed up. Find the rhythm. Four. Three. Two. Yes. Alternating. Right, left, upright. Four, three, two. Bent over back row, same game, alternate. Knee soft, hinge, row. Four. Three, two. Awesome work. We're gonna take it onto the mat in a moment. We'll do our lower weight work first. Reverse fly, alternate. Right, bumps left. Right, move to the left. Four, three, two, right, left, rise up, right arm comes back to the hip, left, fire through that core for stability. Four, three,
two.
One more right. One more left. Hitting chest and triceps on the mat today. Find yourself some space. Lay back. Feet hip width apart, knees bent. Weight in the hands. Elbows at shoulder height. Press. Slow resist down. Arms working together for the first round. Five, four, three, two, one. Weight down. Skull crushers. One hand on either side of the weight. Elbows start over shoulders. Break at the elbow. Weight at forehead press. Five, four, three, two. That single weight down, reverse curl. Legs together, knees soft. Lift the low back, press the ceiling away at the top. Five. Four, more abdominal focus. Three, two, heels down, toes up, crunch, center. Five, four, three, two, bridge, feet flat, palms down, hips up and hold. Stay here if you want more calf focus, cover heels. If you want more, tap the heels. Five, three, two, heels ground down, slow articulation down. Float the knees in. Let this be your reset. One hand to the left weight, one to the right. Chest press, but now we alternate. Right, halfway down, left. Halfway down, right. Back a tricep, taps down lightly. Knuckles press towards the sky. Four, three, two, one more right, one more left, one weight down, hand on either side of that free weight, elbows over shoulders, bend at the elbow, exhale, press. Five, four, three, two. Reverse fly, arms long, legs draw together, knees soft, roll, press. Five, four, three, two, heels down, toes up, crunch center. Five, three, two.
two. Bridge, flatten out the feet, draw the heels towards the glutes, press the palms, lift the hips and hold. Stay here, hover heels. Stay there, tap. Five, four, three, two, one. Heels down, articulation down. Knees draw in. Roll up. Reset.
Grab a little sip of water.
We're gonna mix it up this round.
Wide plie. So open hip position, shoulders back, chest open, hands to hips, or press the walls away. Wide stance, we're getting nice and low, knees tracking over toes. Four, three, two, bring it down, hold. Hands to prayer, heel taps. Five, four, three, two, shake it out, jumping jack. Four, three, two, reset, grab your larger weights. Bicep two overhead press combo. So hammer curl to Arnold. Back to Arnold. Release. Two more. Last one. Upright row, alternating. Four, three, two. At the bottom, one round of shrugs. Shoulders up, shoulders down. Four, three, two, heels up. Half raise. Five, three, two, bent over back row, alternate. Five. Three, two, awesome. Weights down. Smaller weights up. Reverse fly. Alternate. Right, left, one together. So right, left, together. Right, left, together. Two more. Again. Awesome. One arm moves forward, one moves laterally to the side. Switch. Shoulder height. Two more. One more. Awesome. Weights down. Lateral lunge. Step to the left. Move to the right. Third round of these. four, three, two.
Quick shuffle to the right, move to the left. Five, four, three, two, jumping jack, four, three, two, one. Couple standing spinal twists before we hit the mat. Grab those larger weights one more time and bring them back with you. Arms working together, but we'll mix it up. We'll go all the way up, halfway down, back up. High range. Three, two, move to that mid, come all the way down, back, mid, down. Four, three, two, full range, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one weight down, skull crusher, same game, we'll mix them up. How we do it, full range begins. I bring it to the top of the forehead, halfway up, back down. Find the halfway point, full range, halfway down, back up. Three, two, full range, go. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, weight down, reverse curl, final round, press, lower, lower abdominal focus. Five, four, three, two, feet down, heels down, toes up, crunch. Not missing a beat, add rotation. Leg lifts a few inches towards the elbow as we rotate. Four, three, two, bridge, arms long, head heavy, feet hip width apart, press through into the ground and lift those hips up. Stay here, hover those heels. Stay heel hovers, feet flat or add in taps. Six, four, two, hold. Slow articulation down, float the knees in. Right knee stays in, left leg goes long, gaze over right shoulder, bicycle. Three, two, one, go. Four, three, two. Head heavy, knees in. Arms to table, legs. Switch that. Legs to table, arms. Palms facing kneecaps, inhale, right arm, left leg. Bring it back to center, left arm, right. Find that diagonal line of movement. Oh. arm, left leg. Left arm, right leg. Knees in. Roll up. Find your way on to a forearm plank position. So elbow, shoulder alignment. Curl toes, press hips, and hold. Settle in, shoulder, hips, hips through heels. Side plank, back of the room. Elbow, shoulder stacked, feet stacked, split, or modified. Right elbow down, stack the shoulder, rotate towards the front. Closing in on it. And around a plank center. Layer in a saw if you want more intensity. Three, two, side plank, back of the room. Stay here, add a hip drop. Five. Move to center. Stack joints. Layer in that movement if you did on the other side. Five. Lower onto the belly. Press the feet into the earth. Lift center. Lower center. Rise, gaze right. Lower center. Rise, gaze left. Right. Left. More to each side. Stack the hands, rest the head, bend the knees, lift your leg with those legs. Lengthen the legs, feet hip width apart, arms to goddess, rise up, hold up. Let her kick those legs. Ten. Back body strength. Five. Rest the head, bend the knees, make sure you look at those legs. Toes and heels together. Arms extend long, palms up. Rise up and hold up. Ten. Five. Slide the hands into the shoulders. Press the glutes to heel the right child. Head heavy. We're going to stretch all major muscles work. Let's find our way back onto the belly. Take the form under the forehead. Take the hand towards the left heel. And pull the heel towards the glute. Breathe down the length of the front of the quadricep on that left side. Release the left. Take the forearm under. Forehead on that left side. And then right hand moves to heel and holds the glute. Thank you.
the leg. Come back through child's. Curl pose, press hips. Down dog. Begin to pedal it out. Keep one heel high, one heel low, getting into the calf and hamstring. Switch. Both heels down, walk the feet forward and fold. Rise and fall a few times, and then soft knees, head heavy. Shake your head yes, shake your head no. Any tension in the upper back, head, neck, and shoulders, let it release. Two dragged arms, drop the hand to elbow stillness, do a little pendulum swing. Arms heavy, soft knees, strong core, rise up.
Reach for the ceiling, wiggle the shoulders out of the hips, move to the right. Rise center, move left. Rise center, move right. Center, left. Standing reverse pigeon. Again, if you need something for stability, please find it. We'll start by floating that right knee up, open through the hip, place the foot above that left knee, and then sink the hips. Rise up. Pour the weight through the right. Lift the left. Open the hip. Place the foot. Find yourself in space. Again, using something for stability if you need. Rise up, lateral lunge, wide stance, hands to the thighs or to the earth. Move into one side and hold. Move into the left side and hold. Center, nice forward fold, wide legged variation. Once again, encourage any tension, the head, neck, and shoulders to go. Step or hop, feet under the hips, rise up. Press the walls away, targeting biceps. Right arm up, right arm bends. Give yourself a solid pat on the back and pull that arm, targeting tricep. Open, cross, hold. Right arm draws across, left arm draws in. The shoulder blade pull away from the spine. Inhale, open, exhale, left arm draws, right arm pulls. Take it out. So do that standing cat cow, belly in, chin chest round. Exhale, release. Guide gaze up. Down curl pop. Exhale, release. Final twist. Drop shoulder, gaze over opposite shoulder. Switch. One more to each side. Belly breaths, inhale, exhale, inhale, last one, inhale, exhale. Great work today. Thanks for joining me. Fist bump, high five. See you next time. Welcome, and thanks for joining me. I'm Colleen. We're going to be doing a vinyasa flow class today. You're going to want your mat and anything else to help support your practice. We're going to begin by just grounding down, finding our way into our comfortable seat, cross-legged or kneeling, your choice. And then letting ourselves drop in, closing the eyes or lowering the gaze. just begin by letting yourself fully arrive in the here and now, present. Our focus inward, letting wherever we come from go, wherever we're going to next, let that go as well. Choose to be here. Begin to let those hips grow heavy. Feel those sit bones rooting you into the earth below. And from that rooted energy, begin to rise up. Think about lengthening the spine, creating space as you stack each and every vertebra, one on top of the other. The shoulders draw down and back, allowing the chest to open. The neck is long. The crown of the head is reaching towards the sky. Encourage the muscles in the face to soften. Begin to let thoughts come and then let them go. Begin to draw your focus to your breath. Just noticing it, not rushing to change it. Scanning the body for areas of tension, holding. And sending the breath and awareness there to help those areas begin to loosen and soften. Begin to deepen the breath and awareness of breath within the body. Beginning to fill up completely and then empty fully. The nervous system calm, mind be quiet, feeling deeply rooted, connected, and then feeling that extension and lightness. To draw focus to that third eye point, sitting center above the eyebrows, the point of intuition. Draw focus there. Begin to listen. Taking hands to heart center prayer. Press palms together as thumbs tuck back. If you'd like, setting an intention or dedication for your practice. To give the movement we're about to do more meaning. Feel in that intention by nodding chin to chest, let the back, the neck lengthen. Reach the fingertips towards the earth. Begin to roll the head from side to side. The next time that right ear moves towards top or right shoulder, release the left fingertips a little bit lower and hold. In that roll, right, left. Left ear arrives towards top of left shoulder, right fingertips reach. And Let that chin fall heavy towards chest. Take the hands behind the head, embrace the fingertips, let the elbows draw in. And exhale, begin to emerge, press the elbows back, chest forward, arrive, hold here, eyes up. Now take that energy and focus from your third eye point to your heart chakra. Begin to radiate out that positivity and energy. Release the arms. Three sun breaths. Inhale, reach. Exhale, release and let go. Inhale, reach, extend. Exhale, palms to the earth. Inhale. Exhale. Find your way back to child's pose. We'll start restorative. Arms long, palms up. Taking that third eye point once again as your focus into the earth and begin to revolve right to left, awakening and stimulating that point of intuition. And then lengthen the arms overhead, palms down. Fingertips reach away, glutes shift back. Sending awareness to back body. Fill it with breath. Inhale, rise, tabletop. Hands under shoulders, knees under hips. Begin the rhythm of cat-cow. Inhale, belly drop, shoulders open, eyes lift. Exhale, tuck chin to chest, round through the spine, draw the gaze to the navel. Inhale, belly, shoulders, eyes. Exhale, round, curl. And tap. We're moving from root to crown. Crown to root. Inhale, neutral spine table. Extend the right leg behind you. Curl the right toes. Feel length from shoulder to hip through heel. And draw a soft gaze over right shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Inhale, center. Draw that knee into the nose. Exhale, heel towards crown ahead, gaze up. Inhale, knee nose, heel crown. Replace the right knee down. Rebalance the energy. Extend the left leg long. Curl the left toes, press through the heel. Create that length. And draw the gaze over the left shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, over right. Center. Draw that knee to the nose, round. Exhale, release belly down, shoulders up. A moment to remove any tension in the wrists, flipping that grip, palm facing up. Place the right hand, light touch, flip the left, hold. Release the left. Curl the toes, press the hips, downward facing dog. First down dog of the practice, pedal it out. And then find stillness. Hand shoulder width apart, fingertips spread wide. Feet hip width apart, heels energetically reaching towards the earth, but do not need to connect. Knees can be soft, head heavy. Slowly as possible, one foot at a time, walk the feet forward.
feet have arrived under the hips. Take a moment to create length. Then fold and hold, standing forward fold. Ragdoll arms, opposite hand to elbow, stillness, a little movement right to left. Release the weight of the head and the arms, and then slowly rise to stand, knees soft, core strong. Stepping towards the top of the mat and arriving in Tadasana Mountain Pose. Pouring equal weight through the right and left foot. On your inhale, reach the arms. See the hands. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale, lengthen, and prepare. Exhale, right foot steps back, low lunge. Knee ankle alignment on that left side. Pressing through that right heel. Take the left foot back to meet the right, high plank. Slowly articulate down onto the earth, drawing the elbows in towards the sides. Release the tops of the feet and peel the chest up, cobra. Right touching hands. Exhale back through hands and knees, curl toes, press hips. Downward facing dog. Arrive and breathe. Inhale, right leg high, right foot steps forward, low lunge, knee over ankle, back heel, pressing back. The left foot in to meet the right, inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold, inhale, reach, exhale, inhale, lengthen, prepare, exhale, step the feet back to high plank. Articulating onto the earth one more time. Point the toes, lift the chest, cobra. Exhale, back through hands and knees, curl toes, press hips. Downward facing dog. Lift the eyes, see the hands, step the feet in. Lengthen, fold, inhale, reach. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, lengthen, prepare. Exhale, step or hop, high plank. Onto the mat, cobra or now chaturanga, into a strong up dog. Exhale, down dog, arrive and breathe. Inhale, right leg high, right foot forward, arrive, low lunge. Then rock the weight back for wide legged pyramid, hold. Draw the focus to the back of that right leg. Send that right knee back over the right ankle. Take the right foot back to meet the left, high plank. Onto the mat, cobra, chaturanga, pulling into up dog. Exhaling, down dog. Inhale, left leg high, left foot forward. Low lunge, shift the weight back, lengthen left leg, reach right heel towards the earth. Breathe into the back of that left leg. Set the left knee over ankle. Take the left foot back to meet the right. High plank. Chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Lift the eyes. See the hands. Step or hop the feet forward. Lengthen. Fold. Inhale, reach. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, lengthen. Prepare. Exhale, step or hop. High plank. High plank, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg high, right before to arrive. Warrior one. holding these postures a little bit longer, really building the foundation. Toes are soft, knee ankle alignment on that right side, hips squared, back edge of left foot pulling towards the back of the mat. Shoulders soft, neck long, gaze forward. Exhale, hands to the earth, step back and flow, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, left leg high, left forward, ride. Virabhadrasana one and hold. Left knee tracking to the left edge of the foot. Right foot grounding back. Belly drawing inward, shoulders soft. Inhale here, exhale, hands to the earth. Step back and flow. We'll meet and downward facing dog. Building on that, inhale, right leg high, right foot forward to rise. Warrior one, exhale, transition. Warrior two, hold. Wristy set off front, middle finger. Equal extension from fingertips to fingertips. Windmill the arms, step back, high plank. Chaturanga, inhale up dog, exhale. Down dog, arrive and breathe. Inhale, left leg high, left foot forward. Warrior one. Exhale, warrior two, hold. Shoulder blades drawing down and back, chest open, neck long, right touching toes. Windmill the arms, step back and flow. We'll meet in down dog. Lift the eyes, see the hands, step or hop the feet forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach for the sky. Exhale, prayer hands. Take a moment to recall intention, dedication. Release the palms forward to Tadasana Mountain Pose. Equal weight, right to left. Breathe, be still. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, swan back down. Inhale, lengthen, prepare. Exhale, right foot steps back, high lunge. Left foot lengthens, wide-legged pyramid. Right knee grounds down, right toes uncurl, shoulders stack. Shift hips down, opening right quad. Inhale, arms up, Anjaleyasana. Draw focus back to that heart chakra, radiating positive energy out. The hips back, send the hands down, left foot flexes. Focus moves into the back of that left hamstring and calf. Bring the weight back into that left foot. Step the left foot back to meet the right, high plank. Chaturanga, inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Couple deep belly breaths, let it go. Inhale, right leg high, right foot forward, arrive. Low lunge, shift the weight, arrive. Wide legged pyramid. Left knee meets the earth, left toes uncurl, shoulders stack over hips, release the hips towards the earth. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, shift the hips back, flex the right foot, bow down. Weight back into the right, uncurl the left toes, step the left foot in to meet the right. Take an inhale to lengthen. Exhale, place that left hand center. Inhale the right arm high. Inhale here, exhale, right hand moves to where left hand left the imprint, and then left arm moves on. Gaze follows. Toe the feet, toes out, heels in, and arrive in your yogic squat. Elbows press into those thighs, prayer hands. Neck long, shoulders back, chest open. Place the hands, lengthen legs, hold. Rise to fingertips, heel toe the feet, toes together, heels about an inch apart. Draw the knees and the thighs together. And then rise up, full chair. Prayer hands, sink. Twist, left elbow to outside of right thigh. Gaze moves over that right shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, move left. Right elbow catches left thigh. Gaze moves left. Inhale, center. Exhale, rise up, lengthen arms. Move right. Rise, center. Exhale, move left. Open to five-pointed star. Drop shoulders, open chest, gaze up. Exhale, hinge and fold. Inhale, lengthen, prepare. Exhale, bow down and breathe. Intensifying the hand position, maybe flipping the grip, taking hands to the outsides of the ankles or the peace finger toes. Now rise to fingertips, move the energy into that right leg, left leg lengthens. Lift that right heel, pivot the left toes towards the ceiling. Partial balance or full. Setting your drishti on one fixed point for optimal balance. Hands back to the earth. Move into that left leg. Right leg lengthens. Lift the left heel. Pivot the right toes towards the sky. Partial for full balance. Back to the earth, right and left a few times. Send the weight back into that front leg, step the right foot in, lengthen, fold, inhale, reach, exhale, prayer hands. Balance, challenge, pour the weight into the right, lift that left knee high. Open that left leg, place that flex foot above the right knee.
Once it's arrived, prayer hands. Hinge those hips back, reverse pigeon. Rise up, lengthen the left leg, invite that right knee up, open to that right hip, place that foot above the left knee, flex foot, prayer hands, hinge, hold. Rise up. Step back towards the top of the mat. Step that right foot back, preparing for pyramid. Feet are hip width apart, both feet facing forward. Inhale, drop shoulders back, gaze up. Exhale, fire the core, hinge at the hips. Inhale, lengthen, prepare, create space. Exhale, move into that space and hold. More breaths, stay with the work. We draw the hands back to the hips, lengthen and rise up. Right foot steps in to meet left, left foot steps back. Hip width, squared hip, shoulders back, chest open, exhale, hinge. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold and hold. More breaths. Hands to hips, lift the eyes. Heart follows. Step the left foot in to meet the right. Inhale, reach for the sky. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, lengthen, prepare. Exhale, stepper, hop, high plank. This time all the way onto the earth. Point the toes, lift the chest. Cobra. Exhale, release. Inhale. Sphinx. Elbows. Stack under shoulders. Palms press. Shoulders back. Chest open. Neck long. Gaze forward. Full breath here. Exhale, release. And press back to child. Breathe into that back body. Reconnect with that third eye point with intuition. Back onto the belly.
Lengthen the arms, palms up, toes and heels together, and then rise up, look. Slide the hands back under the shoulders, press back through hands and knees, curl toes, press hips, down dog, arrive and breathe. Inhale, right leg high, right knee draws forth between the hands, left toes creep back, maybe filling void under right hip. Inhale, exhale, melt into pyramid pigeon, coming all the way down. Forearms block the mat, support the weight of the head. Being present with each and every inhale and exhale. Encouraging those hips to grow heavier with each and every passing breath. Breath here. And slowly rise to fingertips, curl toes, press it, down dog, pedal it out. Settle into stillness. Inhale, left leg high, left knee forward, right toes draw back. Inhale from root to crown. Exhale, fold pigeon. Space on the inhales, move into it on the exhales. Rounds of breath, stay with us. Inhale, rise. Sink into that left hip, swing those legs around. Take the bottoms of the feet together, knees fall out. Add a little movement right to left. Take those hands where they are, or slide the arms under as we move to a bind and a C curve, forward fold, head heavy. Drawing energy up through the sit bones, let it run the length of the spine and pour out through crown and head. Slowly rise, lengthen those legs, flex those feet. Take an inhale to find length. Stay here or begin the process of folding at the hips, hinging, finding your end point, and then releasing.
Inhale, rise up. Arms long, slow articulation back, one vertebra at a time. The arms overhead, reverse that inhale, arms, ears, rise up. Reach towards the toes, bow the head. Inhale, stack the spine, slow articulation back. Inhale, arms, ears, rise. Lengthen, round, curl, stack, slow articulation down, one more. Arms, ears, rise, reach, lengthen, round, reset, and this time articulate all the way down, hollowing out through the core. Float the knees into the chest and give them a hug. Place the feet hip width apart, heels close to glutes, palms down towards the earth. Preparing for bridge, rock the hips back and then send them high. Stay with the palms down or begin to collect the shoulder blades beneath you. Open chest position, draw focus back to that heart chakra. Radiate out that positive love and light. Full breath here, release the palms, slow articulation down, float the knees in, gentle rock right to left. Right knee in, left leg long. Make any tension out of that right ankle. And the spinal twist, we'll take the left hand to the outside of the right leg, take the left hip underneath the right hip, and move the right leg to the left side of the mat. Once it's arrived, gaze can move over towards the right shoulder. Let it go. Full breath here. Slowly untwist, resetting the hips beneath you. Float the knees in. Left knee in, right leg long. Tension out of that left ankle. Keep that right hip under that left. Let the left leg move to the right. Gaze move left. More full breath here. And then slowly untwist, hips back beneath you, knees draw in. Gentle rock from right to left. And create a little circle. Those knees pressing the low back and massaging it into the mat. Your happy baby hands, the insides or outsides of those flexed feet. Stillness for gentle movement. Let the bottoms of the feet meet and the knees fall out for butterfly. Arms float overhead. Once again, a little movement, then settle into stillness. Begin to take your focus back inward. Head heavy, shoulders, hips heavy. Begin to lengthen those legs. Let's take a little crescent movement before we settle into Shavasana. Take the right foot to the edge of the mat, left foot crosses. Right arm arrives in the upper right hand corner of the mat. Left arm draws over. Right hand takes the left wrist and gently encourages length down that left side body. Think about airing out the left ribs, feeling expansion. And slowly move the left foot to the left side of the mat. Right foot follows and crosses. Left arm moves to the left. Right arm draws over, and then left hand gently pulls that right. Breathing down the entire right side of the body. Inhale, reach the fingertips, flex the feet, reach the heels, and then let it go. Lengthen the arms, let the toes turn out, let the head be heavy. As you settle into your final resting pose of Shavasana, nothing left to do but reap the benefits of your practice. The mind is quiet, letting the weight be held by the earth below. Let it go. And you draw focus back to the breath. You can make that breath bigger than the body itself. On the inhale, energetically draw the energy past the sides of the body. Exhale, draw the energy back inward towards center. Inhale to expand energy outwards. Exhale, pull the energy inwards. Inhale to fill up. Exhale to draw in. You can feel the rise and fall of the belly, expansion of ribs. Wiggle the fingers. Bend the toes. Gentle rock of the head from right to left. Send the arms overhead. Flex the feet. Float the knees in and give them a hug. Gentle rock right to left. Eventually rolling under the right side of the body. Use the right arm as a cradle for the head. And then use the strength of the left hand to press the body up to comfortable seat, cross-legged or kneeling. Drawing gaze towards the earth or closing the eyes completely. Ending a couple minutes of quiet meditation. The spine is long. We found our comfortable seat. We're keeping thoughts at bay. And all our focus is on the breath. Time the mind wanders, which it will, bring it back to the breath. Stay present in this moment. Join hands, a heart center prayer, press palms, the thumbs tucked back, calling intention or dedication. And drawing the focus back to that heart chakra, sending out that positive energy to ignite that dedication. And draw those prayer hands up towards a third eye point, thumbs pressed back. About energizing that point of intuition into that dedication, letting it move out into the world to benefit others. I thank you for joining me. I hope you leave full of love, light, and trusting your intuition that lays within and is always leading you. I bow to you. Namaste. May you be happy, may you be healthy, be well.